We did a miniseries on this about 3 years back, and it was amazing. One program was called Camels from A to Z, from A to Z. And for each initial, there was one fact about camels. And the fact just went on and on. It was really, I just took some of the highlights today. But we intend to talk about it more, and we intend to talk about why this is so important medically, because in particular, the viral diseases like hepatitis, HIV, herpes, and things like this have been found to be, shall we say, susceptible to the camel's milk. The actual antibodies in the camel's milk has a very high antiviral ability. It has the ability to destroy viruses. And in many places, a lot of research is going on now about hepatitis, herpes, AIDS, and other types of viral diseases that basically are treatable but not curable in many cases. But they're finding that the camel's milk greatly diminishes the morbidity and the mortality from these diseases. So this is something that we really need to talk about more. And also, for instance, one of the earliest discoveries about the amazing camel's milk was in Central Asia, that area above Pakistan, like Uzbekistan, Tajikistan, that those areas used to be part of the USSR. They have camels there. And there's a lot of cancer in that areas. And what they found is that the people who had the various cancers and were on chemotherapy did much better if they were drinking camel's milk. So one of the earliest discoveries about camel's milk was sparked just a multitude of research centers throughout the world, was that the patients with cancer that were receiving chemotherapy, if they were getting camel's milk regularly, number one, it decreased the side effects of chemotherapy, which is almost practically a poison. And at the same time, it increased the beneficial aspects of the chemotherapy. In other words, the patients got better. Many of them went into remission. And the side effects of the chemotherapy, such as severe nausea and vomiting, the falling out of hair and all like this, was minimized if the people were drinking camel's milk at the same time. So there's some synergism, or should we say cooperation, between camel's milk and chemotherapy. So this was one of the earliest discoveries years back. And then from there, it went on to go into other places, and we're going to talk about that in coming sequences. Now, what does the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, say about camel's milk? Well, in Sahih Muslim, there's a very nice hadith about camel's milk. Okay? You will find this hadith in Sahih Muslim. In the Sahihan, it is narrated that Anas ibn Malik, Rayla Anhu, may Allah be pleased with him, said, some people of the tribes of Ukul and Urayna came to Al-Madina, and its climate did not suit them. The climate of Medina did not suit them. So the Prophet, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, peace be upon him, ordered them to go to the herd of camels reserved for charity, reserved for sadaqah, and drink their milk and urine as a medicine. Drink the camel's milk and the camel's urine as a medicine. So they went as directed. After they became healthy, they killed the shepherds of the Prophet's camels and drove away all the camels, thus becoming aggressors against Allah and his messenger, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Prophet, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, sent men in their pursuit, and they were captured. The Prophet, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then ordered their hands and feet to be cut off, and it was done. And their eyes were branded with heated pieces of iron. They were then kept in the sun until they died. Such an ungrateful people they were. But this hadith has many lessons. First of all, these people were non-believers. They did not believe in Allah. They came to Medina to investigate Islam, but they did not accept Islam. And because the climate of Medina was quite different from the climate of their homeland, they became sick. And according to most research, they developed a type of liver problem, okay? They had some type of liver infection, okay? Like hepatitis type of infection. It was similar to hepatitis. So when they drank the milk and urine of the camel, they became well. So the first lesson is that When it comes to some of the medicines of the Prophet, peace be upon him, you don't have to believe in Allah to get benefit from this medicine. Of course, if you have faith in Allah, this increases the chances that you'll get benefit from any medicine. The stronger your faith, the more of a chance that Allah is going to heal you and help you. But in this case, these people were clearly disbelievers, and they rejected the message of Islam. But even though they did that, still they received great benefit from Islamic medicine and Islamic treatment. And they were actually cured from their disease, which was similar to hepatitis, or an infection, an inflammation of the liver by camel's milk. So instead of showing gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they transgressed. Allah says in the Quran that if he gives you a ni'mat, he gives you some type of reward, and you're grateful, you're thankful, he'll give you more. But if he gives you some type of a reward, a blessing, and you're not grateful, in this case, they were very ungrateful. The actual source of their cure, they destroyed it. The men that were herding the camels, they killed them. And the camels themselves, that was a cause of their cure, they chased away. So they actually tried to destroy and chase away the actual source of their own healing. Then Allah says in Quran, for those people, they get this type of ni'mat and reward, and they're not grateful. Then just wait, for surely the punishment of Allah will come. So if Allah gives you something, you know, some boon, some reward, some ni'mat, you should be grateful. You should be thankful. We should be grateful. I should be grateful. You should be grateful. Our family, we should be grateful, thankful. Alhamdulillah, wa shukrillah, shukrillah, alhamdulillah. Then Allah will give you more. But if Allah gives us some nice thing that makes us happy, some reward, some boon, some ni'mat, and we show ingratitude, we're ungrateful, we're not thankful to Allah, we transgress against Allah, then wait, for surely the punishment will come. So one of the great lessons of this hadith, and it's why I really like this hadith, because a lot of people say, you know, when it comes to hijama and black seed and all of these different Islamic medicines, well, man, you know, if you don't believe in Allah, how can it help you? Well, this shows you that even if you don't believe in Allah, the medicines of the Prophet can still help you. They can still give you great benefit. But if you're not grateful, then surely in time the punishment will come. So now, we haven't talked about camel's milk in nearly 3 years. And we're almost out of time, but I want to make this point. In the coming weeks, we want to rehash the basic points of the benefits of camel's milk. And then we want to bring you the new research and the new developments that have developed over the last 3 years and show you how it's now becoming available to the common person. Because a lot of people say, well, you know, if we don't live in the desert, how can we get camel's milk? Well, until now, there's been a problem. But there are two things that have been developed here in the United Arab Emirates and are still under development that is going to make camel's milk available throughout the world. And I'm not going to tell you what they are. You got to tune in next week and the coming programs to find out. But there's two ways of distributing and spreading camel's milk and the products of the camel's milk throughout the entire world, even in Alaska or Russia, that have been developed right here in this small place called the UAE, United Arab Emirates. And that is going to be the climax or the pinnacle of this series, where we talk about these fascinating new developments, and it happened here where we live in the Emirates. As always, we entertain your questions and comments. You can write me at Medicine in Islam, P.O. Box 111, Sharjah Television, Sharjah, UAE. Or you send me a fax at 971-6531-969. That's 971-6531-969. Or as most people choose to do, you may send me an email at medman@emirates.net.ae. That's medman, M-E-D-M-A-N, at emirates.net.ae. And as our custom on Medicine in Islam, we'd like to conclude all of our programs with a short dua, a short prayer of the Prophet Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, peace be upon him, such that if any mistakes and errors have been made on this program, and most importantly, if any sins have been committed on this program. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in His infinite mercy and grace will forgive us. Subhanallah wa bihamdihi, subhanakallahu wa bihamdika, wa nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk, nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk, nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. Jazakumullahu khayran. May Allah reward you with the very best, Islam.